So, this is a joint work with Maria Carmela Ceparano and Jacqueline Morgan on approximation of Nash equilibria in static non-cooperative games. In particular, I will present some convergent results for a certain family of iterative methods in a class of two-player non-cooperative games that we will introduce that are called ratio-bounded games. And moreover, I will illustrate some numerical approximation schemes related to problems that involves ratio-bounded games. Why does not work? Okay, good. Okay, so in the framework of approximation of Nash equilibria, we focus on methods based on the so-called best response iteration and their relaxed variance. Now, what do we mean by best response iteration? In a generic step of a best response algorithm or best response dynamics, the player I, the action of player I is updated by selecting a minimizer of the player I pair of function given fixed the action of the other players. That is, player I chooses a best response to the other actions that comes from the previous step. What do we mean by relaxation is that the updated action of a player I is not exactly the best response of player I to the action of the other players, but it is a convex combination or a non-convex affine combination of the best response to the other player action and his own previous action. The idea is that the players are hired to use some additional memories that concerns his previous action and the previous actions of the other players. Now, our setting is the setting of two-player games where players have a continuum of action and the action set are supposed to be Hilbert spaces, that is, there are no constraints on the strategy sets for the moment. Concerning focusing on game without constraints on the action sets, results on the best response approaches for approximate Nash equilibria are summarized in this table. In particular, here, we highlighted the class of games of each paper and also the type of relaxation. For example, the first result by Sherwin-Loridan is about the convergence of the classical best response algorithm, where no relaxation are involved, in the class of zero-sum games. Then by Morgan, is shown the convergence of a convex relaxation of best response algorithm in the class of zero-sum games. The first result that's been extended by Lien Bassar about the classical best response algorithm in non-in zero-sum game, but also in non-zero-sum games. Then Bassar also investigated the convergence of convex and non-convex affine relaxation of the best response algorithm in games where the best response functions are linear and the strategy set are R or R2. And more recently, we proved the convergence of non-convex affine relaxation of best response algorithm for a certain class of non-zero-sum games. So by looking at this table, many questions may arise. For example, there are some games beside the one considered in Morgan and the one considered in Bassar here where convex relaxations converge. And also the same question applies also for non-convex affine relaxation of the best response algorithm. And moreover, if we have a game, we are able to know what are the affine relaxation that converge to the Nash equilibrium. And if there are several relaxations that converge, which is the one that guarantees the highest speed of convergence? And from a wider point of view, can we identify a unifying property that allows to classify the convergent affine relaxation of best response algorithm? That is a property that says, if it is satisfied, I know that this kind of affine relaxation converges and this other affine relaxation does not converge. So our aim is to answer to all these questions. In order to pursue such an aim, we define a certain class of two-player games that is called ratio-bounded games. This class of games, in particular, allow to distinguish four subclasses. For each one, we investigate the existence uniqueness of Nash equilibria, which types of affine relaxation globally converge to the Nash equilibrium, and what is the best algorithm in sense of speed of convergence. What we will provide is a full classification of the convergent affine relaxation of the best response algorithm in this class of games, together with error estimations. And moreover, regarding to the literature, we will enlarge the set of games whereby specific relaxation converge, and also, from another point of view, the set of convergent affine relaxation that converge for a specific game. Then, after investigating the convergence of affine relaxation best response algorithm in this class of ratio bounded games, we will illustrate two numerical approximation schemes, one for the Nash equilibrium of a ratio bounded game and another one for the solution of a certain bilevel Nash equilibrium problem that involves ratio bounded games. So let's go into the mathematical framework. We are dealing with the two-player non-Markov game gamma. We denote by capital Xi the action set of player I, and by capital Fi the payoff function of player I. And in this setting, we denote also by capital Bi the best response correspondence of player I, that is the set value map that assigns to each action of the player who is not I, the set of action on player I that minimize the payoff function of player I given the action x minus y. This is the classical characterization of Nash equilibrium in terms of best reply correspondences. And in the particular case that it is the case that we will use, that the best response correspondences are single valued, are well defined so called best response functions that are denoted by bi, and also the composition of the best response function theta. It is the composition of best response of player one and best response of player two. In this setting, a couple, x bar one, x bar two, is an Nash equilibrium if and only if x bar one is a fixed point of the function theta, and x bar two is the best response to the action of player one, x bar one. Now, this is a mathematical setting, and let us define the two main ingredients of this presentation, that is the class of methods that we are interested in, the affine relaxation of best response algorithm, and the class of games that we will consider, that is the class of ratio bounded games. So let's start with the definition of affine relaxation of best response algorithm associated to a certain parameter delta. It's called also delta Abra for short. Now, given some initial point, this is step n of the affine relaxation best response algorithm. First of all, to avoid the double indices, we denoted by V the variable of player two and by U the variable of player one. So in the generic step n, the updated action of player two is the best response of the previous action of player one. Instead, the updated action of player one is not the best response of player one to the action VL, but it is a affine combination of this best response and his previous action. So by looking at this combination, depending on the variable delta, we can recognize different combination here, and so also different kind of relaxations. So if delta is equal to zero, we can recognize the classical best response algorithm. There is no relaxation in this case. When delta is in 0, 1, this is a convex combination, and so the algorithm is called the convex relaxation best response algorithm. And when delta is less than zero, greater than one, this one is an affine non-convex combination, and so we call the algorithm affine non-convex relaxation of the best response algorithm. So this is the kind of iterative method that we want to investigate. And now let us define the class, ratio bounded games. So we assume that the action set are Euclidean spaces. This can be also extended to when the action sets are Hilbert spaces. We assume some strongly convex assumption on the follower payoff function, on the player I payoff function with respect to his own variable. and moreover some smooth condition on the payoff function plus the invertibility of the Hessian matrix, and moreover, what is important, we require that this supremum that involves the second order derivatives of the function fi must be a real number. Under this assumption, in particular, we have that the best response correspondences of the game are single valued, so it is possible to define b1 and b2, the best response functions. Moreover, we have some...
Francesco, can you interpret a little bit the assumption in A2, especially the last part?
Okay, can I, sorry?
Can you give a kind of interpretation to this assumption?
Yes, the idea behind this assumption is that this is the more or less the derivative of the best response. So this is a kind of upper bound of the derivative of the best responses. This is the idea of interpretation that I can give.
Okay, I see. Thank you.
You're welcome. So under these assumptions, we have also some regularity condition of the best response functions. And moreover, lambda I is an upper bound for the Lipschitz constant of this function bi. And moreover, we have that the composition of best response functions is continuously differentiable and Lipschitz continuous, and Lipschitz constant is no greater than the product of lambda 1 and lambda 2. This parameter lambda will be very important for the sequel of the presentation and for the definition of Rasche bounded game. Now, let us consider this new operator, this new matrix. This matrix involves the second order derivatives of the function capital F1 and F2, and it is well defined given the actions, given the assumption that we have seen before. And this is crucial for the definition of Rasche bounded games. In fact, a game is alpha beta Rasche bounded if these this ratio, this quotient, is bounded from below by alpha, from above by beta. And moreover, alpha and beta are not required to be real numbers, in the sense that alpha can be minus infinity, but beta must be real. And if beta is plus infinity, alpha must be real. Otherwise, all the games are ratio bounded. So if there is there are two bounds, alpha and beta, then the game is called is Rasche bounded. Now, let's see some examples of Rasche bounded games. For example, in the class of Rasche bounded games, there are the quadratic games, extended quadratic games, so where the player per function are composed by a quadratic term, a linear term, something that depends on the other player action, and a bilinear term. Here we can recognize also the in this class, the classical class of quadratic games, the class of weighted potential games, when d1 times d2 is greater than zero, and also the class of antipotential games, when d1 is equal to minus d2. Moreover, in this class, there are also games that are not quadratic, for example, games that where the payoff function takes this form, where Ri and Pi are not necessarily quadratic. In this case, the game is ratio bounded if this infimum of the second order derivative is positive, is a positive number. And this is an example that involves non-quadratic payoff functions.
Moreover, May I interrupt one more time? Sorry.
Yes.
So you are mentioning that when d1 and d2 are positive, there is a relationship with potential gains. Yes. Can we say something in the other way around?
In the other way around, so if it is a potential game, if the game is a potential game, the function takes this form. If it is a quadratic potential game, no, in general, no, because this is a kind of a quadratic weighted potential game.
Okay, so you cannot say something
no,
generally in the other direction.
I, I should be more precise because this is, in fact, this is, we cover the class of quadratic white potential games and the class of quadratic antipotential games.
Okay, thank you, and sorry for the interruption.
No, it's not a problem. Moreover, what is important is that all the games that we have seen in the table of the past results can be recognized all as ratio-bounded games, because in general, the assumptions that are involved in the games that we have seen in the table of past results, we can identify the alpha and beta such that that games are recognized as ratio-bounded. In fact, the games by Chaloy and Loredan and by Liebbasar are ratio-bounded with beta in between 0 and 1. The games considered by Morgan are ratio-bounded with beta less or equal than 0. The ones by Bazar are games with alpha equal to beta, and the one considered by us recently are ratio-bounded games when alpha is greater than 1. Now we are ready to look at the results on the convergence of the affine relaxation best response algorithm when in the class of ratio-bounded games. Now, given a ratio-bounded game, gamma, we have three key parameters, alpha and beta, that are the bounds of the two, that are the bounds of the quotient involving the matrix H that is crucial for the definition of ratio-bounded, and moreover, this other parameter, lambda, that is the product of lambda 1 and lambda 2, that are the two parameters connected to the Lipschitz continuity of the best response functions. Now, depending on how alpha, beta, lambda are ordered each other and also with respect to one, we can identify 8 situations. We collect the situation that lead to the same result, and we now distinguish 4 cases, lambda less than 1, alpha greater than 1, 1 in between beta and lambda, and 1 in between alpha and the minimum of beta and lambda. Now, for each of these cases, we investigate the existence uniqueness of Nash equilibrium, convergence of the affine relaxation of best response algorithm, and moreover, which is the best algorithm in sense of speed of convergence. So let's start with the case C1, lambda less than 1, contracted case, because in this case, the composition of the best response function is a contraction. In this case, it is well known that the game has a unique Nash equilibrium, x bar 1, x bar 2, where x bar 1 is the unique fixed point of the contraction theta, and x bar 2 is the best response to the action x bar 1. But what we can say about the convergence of the affine relaxation of best response algorithm? For a moment, consider a ratio-bounded game that satisfies case C1, and for a moment, suppose that alpha cannot be minus infinity. In this case, we can show that both the classical best response algorithm, both the convex relaxation best response algorithm, and both infinitely many non-convex affine relaxations of the best response algorithm converge to the unique Nash equilibrium. This means that the sequence generated by this algorithm delta abra converges when delta is equal to 0, when delta is in between 0 and 1, and for infinitely many values of delta that are less than 0. So we have a non-convex relaxation. We have convergence of the values of the pair of functions. Moreover, we have also error estimation, un, vn, the sequence and this has this error estimation where tau of delta is a number in between 0 and 1. In the case alpha equal to minus infinity, we have that this result hold, but when delta is in 0 and 1, we can prove that the classical best response algorithm and any convex relaxation converge, not for the non-convex affine relaxation. Now, with respect to the literature on this case, this is just to convince you that we made a step further in the literature on this case, because this kind of situation has been analyzed also only for zero-sum games by Morgan and only when best response are linear by Bazar. And this is an example of a game that does not belong to these two classes and for which our theorem applies. Now, there are also three types of affine relaxations of the best response algorithm that converge to the uniqueness equilibrium. Let us ask which is the one that ensures the highest speed of convergence. We measure the speed of convergence by minimizing this tau of delta, that is the parameter that is involved in the error estimation of the sequence generated by the algorithm. And what we can see that when alpha and lambda satisfy this condition, then the best algorithm is the non-convex affine relaxation. When beta and lambda satisfy this one of these two conditions, then the best algorithm is the convex relaxation of the best response algorithm. We computed also the parameter delta, that is in 0,1. And in the remaining cases, the best algorithm is the classical best response algorithm when delta is equal to 0. Now, we also have an example where actually these three cases, these conditions may be checked and actually occur. And we use the class of non-quadratic gains, and we have that for some value of the parameters of the game, we have that in some cases the best algorithm is the non-convex affine delta algebra, in other cases the convex delta algebra, and in other cases the classical. The classical best response algorithm. This is for case C1. Let's move now to case C2. Case C2, super monotone case, because theta is a super monotone operator. When alpha is greater than one, the best composition best response function is a super monotone operator. This means that is a strongly monotone operator with constant of monotonicity greater than one. It's a particular kind of expansive thing. In this case, we recover the result that we obtained 2 years ago, that when gamma is a ratio bound of games and KC2 is satisfied, the game has a uniqueness equilibrium. We are ready to prove that the non-convex affine relaxation of the best response algorithm converge to the uniqueness equilibrium. That is for the value of delta that are in this interval, that is since delta is greater than one, we have the non-convex affine relaxation. Even in this case, convergence of the values and error estimations. And we can also identify which is the delta corresponding to the algorithm with the highest speed of convergence. This delta is a particular delta that is greater than zero. So it is a non-convex affine relaxation. Even in this case, we enlarge the literature about the convergence of non-convex affine relaxation of the best response algorithm. And in particular, I want to emphasize also that in case C2, there are examples where the classical best response algorithm and also any convex relaxation do not converge. This is a very simple example, a quadratic example. We can see that if we compute the sequence generated by both the classical best response algorithm and any convex relaxation, these algorithms do not converge. So only convex relaxation, non-convex affine relaxation are sure to converge in this case. KC3, one in between beta and lambda, called pseudo-contractive because in the particular case where beta is greater than zero, theta is called the generalized pseudo-contraction mapping. But in this case, we have the uniqueness of Nash equilibrium again. In this case, the convex relaxation of the best response algorithm converges to the uniqueness equilibrium, that are the delta abra associated with delta in this interval, that is subset of 0,1, so we can recognize the convex relaxation. Again, convergence of values, error estimations, and we can also identify the algorithm with the highest speed of convergence, that is a convex one. Even in this case, we enlarge the literature on the convergence of convex relaxation best response algorithm that had been shown to converge only for the class of zero-sum games. And moreover, this is also an example, since in the in the presentation, we used a lot of games with a bilinear interaction term. Here, there is an example of game, of Russia-bounded game with non-bilinear interaction term that belongs to KC3 and for which applies the theorem that we have now seen. Now, KC4, not everything can work well. This is not surprising for maybe. In this case, C4, when one is between alpha and the minimum between beta and lambda, the game is not guaranteed to have a unique Nash equilibrium. And moreover, even when the game has a unique Nash equilibrium, no one of the affine relaxation is assured to converge. This is shown by some counterexamples. In these four examples, all the games are Russia-bounded games that satisfies KC4. But in the first case, we have no Nash equilibria. In the second case, we have three Nash equilibria. In the third case, we have infinitely many Nash equilibria. And moreover, in the fourth case, we have, we have a unique Nash equilibrium, and we can show that for any delta, the affine relaxation of best response algorithm with parameter delta does not converge. So this means that in this case, it is not possible to obtain a positive result analogous to the ones that we have seen in the three cases before. What we can do, we can observe that alpha and beta, the bounds of the ratio that define the Russia-bounded games, are lower and upper bounds, and so are estimations of the lower upper bounds of that quotient. So, if we refine a bit, if we are able to refine a bit these two estimations, we can fall in the KC2 or in the KC3. And so we can obtain some results. These are the best estimations for alpha and beta, but however, these two kinds of estimation are not easy to be achievable in practice. Moreover, we highlight also that this ratio, that defined ratio band, the ratio band of games, is the Rayleigh quotient of this matrix. So, some theory, spectral theory about the range of this quotient can be helpful in determining the lower and upper bound of this ratio. So, to summarize, we have that. If gamma is a Russia-bounded game and one of the three cases, the good cases, C1 to C3 are satisfied, we can look by column this table. We have a uniqueness of Nash equilibrium in the three cases. Moreover, we can see that the classical best response algorithm converges in case C1, the convex relaxation best response algorithm converges in case C1 and C3, and non-convex affine relaxation converges in case C1 and C2. In case C4, we are not this result. We can show that we are not able to obtain the same results. So, Russia-bounded games can be a natural environment to study the behavior of the best response approaches. Moreover, we can identify also which is the algorithm associated with the highest speed of convergence. We have also error estimations. About the algorithm with the higher speed of convergence, we can identify this delta star, and depending on the alpha, beta, and lambda, we have that the best algorithm can be the non-convex relaxation in this case, or the convex relaxation in this situation, or in this situation, the classical best response algorithm. And these are the error estimations for UN, BN, sequence generated by the algorithm that involves these number. Now, by looking at the generic step n of the affine relaxation best response algorithm, this algorithm involves the analytic expression of B1 and B2 that are the best response functions of the player. However, the best response function of the player is not not always achievable, or in a sense, the analytic expression is not always available. So, in this case, we move to the numerical approximation. I need an optimization tool that is able to approximate these two quantities, the best response of player 2 to UN minus 1, best response of player 1 to VN. But these two quantities are just minimizers of strongly convex functions because by definition of best response function. So I look for a new sequence U star n, V star n, that is constructed in this way by these three steps. Starting from un minus one star, we need an approximation of V2 to get Vn star, then an approximation of V1 to obtain this U and tilde, and then I need also the affine combination to compute Un star, because I'm interested in Un star, Vn star. We illustrate two globally convergent numerical approximation schemes for two different kinds of problems. First one, Nash equilibrium of a ratio bounded game, and the second one to the solution of a bilevel Nash equilibrium problem with ratio bounded lower level game. For both kinds of numerical approximation scheme, we use a unique optimization tool that is called local variation method. I want to spend just a few words about the local variation method. It is a quite old method. First paper is of Cernusco in 1965. Is a kind of direct search method. That is a method, a derivative free method for optimization. And the aim is to find an approximation of the unique minimizer of a strongly convex function. Just to give the insight in the case of n equal one, that is a real-valued functions defined on R, it's very intuitive because we fix an initial point and a certain range or step parameter. We evaluate the function that we want to minimize in two points, one on the left and one on the right of the point zeta zero, and we select the point between zeta zero and zeta zero plus epsilon and zeta zero minus epsilon, which correspond to the minimum of these three values. And we use that the point that we selected that as a trial point for the next iteration. And we stop when we obtain a so-called stable point. It is a point such that the minimum is achieved in the middle, that is satisfies these two inequalities. In this point, if we move on the left or on the right, we obtain a values that are higher or the one that is in the middle, and then we can stop. This is the generalization of the local variation method in the case of a function defined on Rn. It takes as an input the function that I want to minimize, the step parameter, the step size parameter or range, and the initial point, and gives as an output a stable point. That is a point that satisfies these inequalities. This means that if I move along the axis with step epsilon, I don't have a better point. What is important for the local variation method? These two properties. The first one is that it ends in a finite number of steps, and the second one is that the error that we commit in taking the stable point as the minimizer of the function g is linear in the step size parameter epsilon. These two properties are crucial for the convergence of our numerical schemes. And in fact, if we use the local variation method as the optimization tool to find the approximation of the best responses, and at each step we halve the step size parameter of the range, then we have that this new sequence, numerical sequence, under some, if we strengthen a bit the assumption of convexity, and moreover we assume that the second order derivative of the function of the payoff function of player I is bounded, then we have the global convergence of the numerical sequence, the numerical delta abra, to the unique Nash equilibrium of a ratio bounded game, and we have also error estimations, and in particular about the speed of convergence, this sequence converges R linearly to the unique Nash equilibrium. R linearly means that the is a convergent condition a bit weaker than the linear convergence. This means that this sequence is bounded, is dominated by a sequence that linearly converges to zero. So this is about the numerical approximation scheme for Nash equilibrium of Clashof-bounded game. Then we move to find a numerical approximation scheme for a bilevel Nash equilibrium problem, for the solution of a bilevel Nash equilibrium problem. Let me say some few words about the bilevel Nash equilibrium problem. This is a hierarchical structure with two levels. There is a Nash equilibrium problem or a game in the upper or first level, and another one in the lower or second level. The bilevel Nash equilibrium problem is the mathematical model that underlies the multi-leader multi-follower games, or also the so-called equilibrium problem with equilibrium constraints, the EPEC, and it is a clear generalization of bilevel optimization problem or Sackleberg games, where in each level there is an optimization problem. There is a wide range of application in engineering and economics of bilevel Nash equilibrium problem. FTC markets, exploitation of resources for markets, no competition, contract theory, also interaction between governments and business sectors. However, on the other hand, there are a few papers on numerical approximation of bilevel Nash equilibrium problems due to the higher complex nature of the problem. There are some results by Su, De Miguel, and Xu, with Fukushima, Erti Steffens, and Tunen, or Selle Svensson, that provides some numerical approximation schemes for bilevel Nash equilibrium problem under some assumption in some cases. For our problem, we consider a bilevel Nash equilibrium problem where we have in the lower level a two-player Clashof-bounded game. We call, just for simplicity, the players involving in the second stage the so-called follower. And we suppose that this is a Clashof-bounded game and that it is satisfied one of the good cases, C1, C2, or C3. In the upper level, we have instead a parametric two-player potential game that is parametrized by the action profile of the followers. And what does it mean that is a potential game? That there exists a potential function such that if we fix the joint action profile of the followers, the leader payoff function can be written as the payoff function leader I can be written as the sum of the potential function that is common to both the leaders plus something that depends only on the other leader variable. So these kind of games have been introduced by Slade and by Mondra and Shapley. So our problem consists in finding this quadruple x bar 1, x bar 2, y bar 1, y bar 2, such that x bar 1, x bar 2 is an Nash equilibrium of the upper level game that is parametrized by y bar 1, y bar 2, that is a Nash equilibrium of the Nash equilibrium of the Clashof-bounded game in the lower level. This is clearly the characterization of Nash equilibrium of the solution to bilevel Nash equilibrium problem by definition of Nash equilibrium. And we want to just remark that this solution is nothing but a subgame perfect Nash equilibrium of the associated multi-leader multi-follower game. We are in the particular case where the strategies of the where the strategies of the follower are constant. Under some convexity assumption on the payoff on the potential function, we have that the problem has a unique solution that satisfies these two properties. In particular, x bar 1, x bar 2 is the minimizer of the potential function given x bar 1, x bar 2, that is the unique Nash equilibrium of the Clashof-bounded game in the lower level. We want just to emphasize that this uniqueness result cannot be obtained via the classical results about the uniqueness of Nash equilibria, for example, the one of Rosen or the one of Neyman. Now, let's go so in the approximation of the solution to a bilevel Nash equilibrium problem. So, how to approach this solution, we combine the affine relaxation of the best response algorithm in the lower level, where there is a ratio bounded game, and we use also the properties of a potential game in the upper level. And so we come up with this approximation scheme. Now, remember, Vn is the variable of the second follower, Un the variable of the first follower, Wn is the variable of the leader one, and Zn is the variable of leader two. This just to avoid double indices. And as you can see, here we can recognize the affine relaxation best response algorithm, and then we use a best response to Un Vn to find the joint action profile of the leaders. Under some assumption on some regularity conditions, and also this one that is analogous to the one that we have seen on ratio-bounded games, we have that the sequence generated by this approximation scheme converge to the solution of a bilevel Nash equilibrium problem. However, this scheme involves best responses of player one, player two, and also the joint best response function of the leaders. And so we want to move to a numerical approximation method. And we use again the local variation method to approximate the best responses of the players. And in this case, we call the algorithm diagonal local variation method. After some initial condition, we have that we can find the V1 star by applying the local variation method to the function of follower two. Then we move back to U1 tilde star by applying the local variation method to the function of follower one. We make the affine combination, and we found that the UN star, that is the action player of follower one that we are interested in, and then we use U1 star, V1 star to find the joint action profile of the leaders. And then we halved the step size parameter and we continue the method. So in red is the numerical sequence that we are interested in. And again, we have for this numerical approximation scheme, again, by strengthening a bit the convexity assumption on the payoff functions and adding the boundedness of the second order derivatives, we have that the problem has a unique solution, as we have seen before, and the sequence generated by the numerical approximation scheme converge to the unique solution of the problem. We have some error estimations, and moreover, that the sequence generated by the method converge are linearly to this unique solution of the problem. The R linear convergence is in line with the rate of convergence of the local variation method. So, conclusions. We investigated the global convergence of the affine relaxation best response algorithm. To do this kind of investigation, we introduced a new class of games that is called ratio-bounded games, where there is a ratio-boundedness property that allows us to control the behavior of the best responses. And we distinguish four cases. In the first three cases, we are able to have results on the existence and uniqueness of Nash equilibrium in ratio-bounded games, and we can also identify which kind of affine relaxation converge to the unique Nash equilibrium, and we are able also to find which is the algorithm with the highest speed of convergence. In case C4, we can show by counterexamples that we cannot obtain a similar result as the previous ones. And we investigate also two numerical approximation schemes, one for the Nash equilibrium of ratio-bounded games, and another one for a solution of a bilevel Nash equilibrium problem, a particular one, when there is a potential game in the first level game and a ratio-bounded game in the second level. This is only a starting point of research for ratio-bounded games, because in general, we want to find also similar results in the case where there are constraints on the strategy sets, or when the best response correspondences are not single-valued. Moreover, since ratio-bounded games can be defined also in Hilbert spaces, maybe this we have some very easy examples for the moment of differential games that are ratio-bounded. So the idea is also to look at the extension on the use of these ratio-bounded games also for multi-stage games or also in a dynamic frameworks. So that's all. I really thank you for your attention. And this is a list of references, key references for this work. In particular, the blue ones are the working papers where you can find some of the things that I presented today.